Now, with Visual Studio and GitHub, we have the most widely used professional developer tools in the world. And with the Microsoft Power Platform, we also have the most widely used low-code development tools in the world as well. And what I'd like to do now is invite Charles LaManna, who leads our Dynamics 365 and Power Platform engineering team, onto the stage to tell you more about them. Please welcome Charles.
Awesome. Thank you, Scott. So one of the things which is really incredible is that it's not just about Copilot making you faster with code, but also how Copilot can start to show up using things in like low code in the Power Platform. And as Scott mentioned, just it's the world's most adopted low code offering for building applications, analyzing data, automating tasks, and more. But one of the things we were incredibly excited to announce yesterday was Microsoft Copilot Studio. Microsoft Copilot Studio makes it possible to customize and extend the Microsoft Copilot wherever it shows up, but also to go create your own Copilots, drawing from all of the amazing low-code capabilities that we have. And what Copilot Studio can do is it can take advantage of over 1,100 pre-built plugins and connectors to connect to any of your data sources and orchestrate any of your existing workflows. It also supports all the OpenAI standard concepts like plugins and GPTs. It makes it easy for you to make your web app or mobile app or more the Copilot enabled. So for the demo today, I want to take us through and actually build something inside of Copilot Studio. So if we look right here, we can see this is the Copilot that you saw yesterday inside of Microsoft Teams. And like we're all used to, we want to be able to just converse and talk to Copilot to answer our questions and understand what's going on in our business. So in my job, I work with supply chain and suppliers. So I'm going to go see just what's the supplier lead time for one of our common suppliers, Alpine Ski House. And I get back a response. And the reality is Copilot doesn't know how to get that information because it's not inside the Microsoft Graph, and it's not available on the web. But the good news is there's a great extensibility story here. So if I click over, I can see that I can go register plugins. But I can also use Copilot Studio to create a plugin for my systems if a plugin doesn't already exist. So if I go launch this experience, I land right into Copilot Studio, where I can start to build what we call these conversational plugins. And what conversational plugins do is it allow me to register a trigger phrase, which will execute a series of steps or even multi-turn conversations based on what the user has entered. So I'm just going to go in and add this conversational plugin. And this makes it really easy to go extend Copilot kind of however I need to do it for my business. And say if I click through here, I land right into a visual designer that kind of everybody knows and loves from the Power Platform. And inside this designer, the first thing I do is I create what's called a trigger. So with a trigger, I provide details and prompts about when I want to execute this plugin. So this is how Copilot in Microsoft Teams knows when to execute this particular plugin that I've built. In this case, when someone asks about supplier metrics and performance. But of course, I want to take actions and do things in response to that question. So if I click down here, I can use something that we call generative answers. Generative answers allow me to register websites, SharePoint sites, and more, which are then synthesized and replied back to the user to answer their question. And what's great is I can hard code exactly the data sources I want. So if I go click through and use this generative answers, I'm going to get a great experience where I can configure up to 4 different websites and 4 different SharePoint sites where I'll go pull information from to answer the question. And this is just as easy as putting in the URL or selecting the necessary websites and documents. And it's not just web or SharePoint. I'm also able to use Azure AI Studio and other Azure AI capabilities to extend my Copilot. So I can start from low code and go all the way to pro code. So for this case, I already have a SharePoint site where I have documents about supplier information. So I'll just paste in that URL and add it. And this is how I can guide exactly the reply I want inside of my plugin. And to show what it's using, I'll say just click through this URL and look at that supplier fact sheet. It's 20 pages, unstructured data, tables, and information about all the different suppliers that I use inside of my enterprise. And this is a great way to go make sure that all the different supply associates like me can understand exactly what's happening when I'm using Copilot in Teams. So I switch back over to Copilot Studio, select the input text from the question the user asked to pass that into that data source, and able to get all of this wired up very easily and very quickly. Now that I have that, I just go up and save and publish. And what's great is when I publish this conversational plugin, it's not just for me. It can also be for people on my team, or if I'm in the IT organization, I can publish it for the entire company. So I switch back over here, ask that same question I did before, where are the lead times with supplier Alpine Ski House? And I get back an answer. And this answer is from that document. You know, within 10 days of order placement, that's the average delivery time. And this is great, it's good to get started, but the reality is I want to be more interactive and use the data that's stored in my systems of record. My back office knows exactly the expectations for these suppliers. So I'm going to go back to Copilot Studio. I'm going to create a new plugin. And for this plugin, I'm going to use a different set of data sources. So the first thing I'll do is I'll have the same trigger as before. So I'll paste that in because the same types of questions that users are going to ask. But I'm going to use something different. I'm going to call to my SAP instance and a custom REST API I defined to bind together this information and give an answer that's exactly right at that point in time. So for step one, I'm going to go down to that call and action. And here we have those 1,100 plus pre-built connectors and plugins. So whether it's SAP, ServiceNow, Workday, and more, you can connect to it seamlessly in Copilot Studio. So I'll just search for SAP, and I'll be able to get back all the information I care about for the different actions I can execute against my SAP instance. And in this case, I'm just going to read from an SAP table, and I'm just going to go configure a few other things like the table name that I care about and more. And this will allow me to easily pull from that information no matter where it's hosted using the on-premise data gateway if needed to connect on-premise or the standard connectors you already know from Power Platform. But that's only step one. I then want to take the result from SAP and I want to pass it to my custom REST endpoint. And I can do that inside of Copilot Studio by calling this action. And just like we have the 1,100 pre-built connectors and plugins, you can add the 1,101st by registering your own backend systems. So in this case, the order delivery rates API is something that I've created and configured, hosted inside of Azure. And of course, I like Azure API management, so that's where I registered my endpoint as well. So I click through that. And what I start to do is I'm sequencing a bunch of individual API calls to fulfill this question from the user right inside of Copilot. And this sequencing is important because I want to control exactly how I pass information between these two systems to go generate my response. And here, what I've done is I've highlighted something called the generative response. The reality is I don't want to respond back with JSON or unformatted text. I want to synthesize information from both SAP and my REST API back to the user. So I use that generative response. I provide the information from the previous steps just by selecting it inside the designer. And then I'm able to provide a prompt and instructions to guide how I want to format the information and the information I particularly want to highlight. So all of this comes back in a really easy, simple workflow going across lots of different systems to give exactly that real-time information. Now, I click back out. And I'm going to do the same thing I did before, where I go save and publish to Microsoft Copilot. And this will allow me to go ask that question in real time. Switching back to Teams. And inside of Teams, I'll ask Copilot, what are the lead times with supplier Alpine Ski House? And I get an answer, which orchestrates across those two different steps and tells me it gets fulfilled within 10 days of order placement and has an 86% on-time delivery rate over the last 6 months. So all of this can be wired up inside of Copilot Studio, and you can start with low code or go all the way to pro code as needed. And just the last thing I want to talk about real quick is just those connectors and plugins, because this is what we've kept hearing from all of our customers is one of the biggest challenges of Copilot is making it work over your enterprise data. Copilot Studio makes it easy, so you can go build and publish extensions to the Microsoft Copilot. And if you want a Copilot for your own app and your employees, you can build it in Copilot Studio too. Thank you so much for the time today. I'm going to turn it back over to Scott.